So, okay, we are going on with our final presentation for today. The day is called Future Fuels. And we have two interesting guests here from Martin Schempkes, Beneteau Group, and Alex Bamberg, CEO of Aqua Superpower. They will talk about the new infrastructure for boating, for alternative fuels, here on stage for 20 minutes. Very interesting, I promise you. Please, Martin and Alex.
Good afternoon.
Thank you.
We're going to be quick on some infrastructure of charging. Very important by electric boating today. But it fits also in a product which we call sustainability in total. Sustainability on the Group Beneteau today is a footpath over 15 to 20 years. And we are already on that path, going very quickly for what concerns development on sustainability. Picking out one thing of that is electric propulsion. Electric propulsion, which we bring on different boats at the moment, either it's sailing boats or it is on power boats. And we are going now to talk a little bit more on this electric power boats and what is necessary to keep them driving. But first of all, I'd like to show you inside the Group Beneteau, we have three pillars, which is about day boating, real estate, sail and multi-hull. And further, we have the boat solutions division and, of course, the housing division. This is the Beneteau Group in which we announce this sustainability process. Now, for what concerns this sustainability responsibility, goes further than only propulsion, but also building boats and using sustainable materials. One of these materials directly is going into the electric drive of power boats. And there, both Alex and I went together. And we went together because we know that if you want to have electric drive, you need the infrastructure of charging. Maybe you just heard the panel talking about this infrastructure. One thing I am sure about that, if we get electric boats on the water, we need to have the government talking together with us. The government talking together with us means we need an incentive from the government to get electric propulsion driven. It has been done with cars. Everybody knows the success in Oslo, which has been done together with the government. And I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, Alex, because you are on electric car specialist, I think it's already 70% in Oslo on electric cars.
Correct. Yeah.
This is because of the push. I started a committee in the Netherlands together with local governments and with entrepreneurs and investors to take care of the fact that they need to invest in shortcom for electric propulsion and in charging. This pilot will be made in the Netherlands for 100 kilometers trajectory and will be programmed further on in Berlin, in Austria, in the south of Germany, and in Ireland and the UK. This is just the beginning, but it is an example towards the governments which we are going to feed on. So I made a proposal towards Alex and said, you are good in the infrastructure and the charging poles everywhere where you want to plow them. And I need them because I'm bringing boats on the water from Delphia in this case, and we need the charging. Because everybody who wants to drive an electric boat, they have two questions. The first question is, what is my range and where can I charge? Since everybody had this thing, this phone, nobody ever thinks about anymore to charge it. It is automatic. You go automatic. You never drop the battery down to 3% or 2%. You do it already on 10 or 15% every day. With the boat, it's exactly the same. Today, we can drive on the boat for normal shore power, but if we want to go faster charging and further charging, we need you, Alex.
Yes, correct. And I think the analogy there is, again, that we learn the lesson from the automotive and we bring that because it's very obviously the same consumer, but they're in their boat instead of their car.
Right.
And what we found was broadly that one in four charging sessions, if you owned a car, was high power to high speed charging. And this, when that was enabled, i.e. when the infrastructure was deployed for fast charging, that is when the market picked up. This is when you went to 50, 60, 70%, depending on Scandinavia, Norway, Germany, UK areas. This does not happen on the slower AC charging alone. The market will not grow or scale. So the high-powered infrastructure is a key element to satisfy people.
Exactly. So we joined together to see that this is a serious step. And as long as we only speak about it, nothing will happen. So we need action. And again, I said, there's only one thing we can do is to speak to the governments. Everybody knows that there is a EU rule at the moment that is 2030, we need to reduce carbon with 55%. Either it's left, right, it doesn't matter, it needs to be done. So we are in charge, huh?
Yeah, yeah, we have to deploy.
So maybe, Alex, we can see your step out in your company.
Yes, as you can see, we are deploying in various global locations, and these are all driven around a consumer experience. And essentially, we're going to call this an ease of use experience. We do not want people to have any anxiety. So we're building out, we like to say, locally and globally. So the local corridors, we will run charging down coastlines, perhaps every 5 to 10 miles. And in the inland waterways, rivers, canals, and the large lakes, we will surround a lake in charges, which brings tremendous flexibility and removes any fear of running out of fuel, essentially. So this is what we're doing here. At the same time, we also develop all the cloud systems which help inform the user of how where he wants to go, is the charger occupied, is it free to use, etc. This is all very important of the memory and the relaxation of driving an electric boat. I think there is some fun stuff also later on, which brings some commercial and environmental impacts, which can be described as, you heard of vehicle to grid, and here we can talk about boat to grid, and there are some very good advantages with the boat market in this segment, because of the seasonal usage of the boats, and they tend to have larger batteries than the vehicles. So they can make a very good contribution back into the grid. So people get very concerned about, can a national grid support the transition to electric boats or electric cars? And there's a lot of negativity about that. What we're saying, actually, the boat and the car actually provides the solution. And this is a very important thing to get your head around. And not only does it support the grid potentially at peak times, it also allows the owners to be paid back some revenue. So this is an exciting thing. And the modeling of this is ongoing. There are several pilot projects going on, but this is probably a 24-month, 36-month landscape that we're working to. Here you can see a couple of images of a high power charger and the standard that we have pushed, as this was another potential bottleneck, is to assure that all the boat builders comply with a set standard. So when you turn up to a charger, the boat is equipped with the right socket and you can connect and seamlessly charge your vessel. And that is an absolute those that can remember a VHS Betamax problem. We do not want this happening here. It happened early on in the car market, and however, these standards are now being adopted. The advantage of these standards is very much more safety and communication and identification of the user, and allowing ease of use for billing and various other things.
Okay, Alex, let's go back again. As we said, we are on a mission. And this mission is that we don't want to change the world. We're just stepping in a community who is already focused on electric propulsion and alternatives. Many times we spoke about the maritime business changed in the 90s from two-stroke to four-stroke in outboard engines. Everybody thought that four-stroke will never win because we were connected to two-stroke engines they accelerate, etc. They are lighter. Nobody believed that the change towards four-stroke could be done. But it did. Today, there is no two-stroke, actually. That's why we say going to electric, it is on, it is tomorrow. And that's why Aqua Superpower, with their charging infrastructure, together with electric propulsion in boats in general, we are on. It's our mission.
Correct.
Correct?
We need to speed it up. And I would like to say, you know, the world is on fire, and we need to do something about it. And we can't wait all the time. And coming back again to the car market, we were talking to the British government for many years, and they said, oh, London, we're going to fund some of London. We're going to fund some of London. Exactly. 2 or 3 years go by, we're going to fund some of London. What we did, we went out and we raised our own money, and we put 50 superchargers into London. 6 months, the government rings, can we use your photographs? And I said, well, where's your money? And then it snowballed. So we've started it.
Exactly.
We want the government to come now and deliver.
Okay, Alex, thank you very much. I think we are done with the message.
Okay, perfect. Very interesting. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For
thank
coming.
You.
So this was the fourth day of the Blue Innovation Doc. Tomorrow is all about recycling and materials. We start here back at 11 tomorrow.